What's up, YouTube? I'm Brett with my special guest host, Jessica.
Hey.
Today we're going to be doing a episode review of Shadow and Bone, episode 1. As always, guys, if y'all enjoy our content, don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave that comment down below. We're on the road to 1,000. We hope you guys can help us get there. All right, so, Jessica, what did you think of Shadow and Bone, episode 1?
Amazing.
That was amazing?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, my Lord.
I won't go so far to say amazing. I thought it was really interesting show. This is a show that I've been kind of going on and off about whether or not we should do episode reviews or not. She basically talked me into it.
Because I want to see what the second episode.
Yeah, she's like we got to do the second episode.
This is like a binge-worthy show.
It really is a good show. And I tell you, right now I'm reading the books. The book is really good as well. I won't go so far to say that the book is as good as, or at least so far, I'm about halfway through it, as good as what the series is. But, I mean, overall, I think it's actually pretty cool.
And I see it as like an Avatar. If you guys were into Avatar, The Last Airbender. This is like a grown-up version of Avatar because they have powers.
It really actually kind of feels that way. Grisha in this show remind me of the airbenders, firebenders.
They have the people that do wind, they have the people that do the fire and stuff like that. So that's what this reminds me of. And I really didn't grow up with Airbender because
I love that show.
I was too old for Airbender because
I don't care if I was too old, I still enjoyed it. I love it. Still love it to this day. But as far as this, what do you think of the whole Alina Mal situation?
I personally think that they're in love. From a woman's perspective, because I think she likes him. Even though they're really good friends and they were in an orphanage together as kids, I see them as getting married later in the show. That's if everything goes good. I don't know because what I just saw, I don't know if anybody's alive, so I don't know.
That's the whole thing about it is I don't know if who's going to be alive, who's going to be dead. Of course, I've read the book a certain extent of exactly who is alive, who is not alive, but at the same time, I will say, I've enjoyed it. Like, I like the relationship between Mal and Alina probably more in the series than I do in the book. They seem like they got very good chemistry together.
It's like more genuine.
Yeah.
It
really is more genuine.
It's not like it's fabricated.
No.
Like it is
it's
in the
not,
book.
You feel like they're really actually friends. You feel like they really, truly care for one another.
You can see that little spark when they get together. You can see that little sparkle.
I feel like in the book, they exacerbated a little too much. Because that's like one of the first things that they're like, oh, Alina's so in love with him and blah, 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 all this other stuff. And I'm like, I feel like it's more subtle in the series than what it is in the book. But overall, I think the relationship's really good. I mean, it's interesting. It's something that I feel like I can get involved in. Like, I feel like it's something that interests me. You know, you find in so many series where you feel like they're just put together to be put together.
You can see that there's going to be a future somewhere
yeah.
down the line with them.
Yeah.
It's not like...
Well, you feel like they're believable characters in a lot of ways.
But I really
enjoy episode 1. I mean, I don't know if I necessarily like the whole Kaz and Nish storyline as much as I enjoy the Alina and Mal storyline.
Well, he's just a gangster trying to get some money.
Yeah, I know that.
You know, gangsters are going to be tough and stuff like that anyway. So.
Well, I kind of feel like, you know...
He's just trying to make that $1 million.
Yeah, I kind of feel like, you know, okay, Anish and Cass, when it comes to those two, I didn't really understand the story so far, exactly what they were trying to go into. They're trying to go into it. They've got Alexei, or they had Alexei, and you know, that was in the fold, and they're trying to you know, get information of, you know, how they can get basically this son somewhere.
Yeah,
that's
exactly.
That's the main goal of them, is going to be trying to get her.
Alina. They're in the army or military something, and they go into this void.
Fold.
I say void because it looks all black, and that's what a void is to me. Black, dark. Anyway, they go in there, and they're on the ship, and the light, their blue light goes out. Scary. And then all of a sudden, the one person has to get that light and let him. Why would he do that?
I kind of feel like they built up the Grishas as like something, you know, amazing and great.
Yeah, like.
And then they just, like, 2 seconds into the fold, it's like the Grishas were, like, completely and totally useless.
They didn't use their powers.
Well, they used them, but it didn't do anything.
No, they did not use their powers. They were, the captain, the black lady, you know, I don't know what her name was. She's like, come get me.
She literally, they came and got it.
And she's like, come get me. She has powers. I'm sorry. She has powers. And she didn't even use them. I'm like,
Felt like in the book, it seems like they, you know, they're more useful. Where that so far in the series, it just kind of feels like they're basically trumped up as like this big, you know, powerful people that can go into the fold and take out those monsters. And at the end of the day, they were just as helpless as anyone else.
One of the monster things, I don't know what they call them, but I'm going to call them monster things, grabbed up, is her name Elise? Alexei.
No, you're talking about Mal. Grabbed up Mal, and of course, yeah.
Yeah, grabbed up Mal, her childhood friend. And then she saw that, and she shot the thing. Well, he got down. Well, one grabbed her, and apparently, this is why I have to watch the second episode. She has this light, and this light is so bright. It's like ridiculous bright.
She's an amplifier.
She basically let this light out and killed all the little flying creature things. And I don't know what happened.
I feel like when it came to the fold is really beautiful in this series. I tell you, you know, they speak about it in the book. Again, I've only read half of the first book. But they speak about it in the book, and you get like a brief glimpse of it. But I feel like the series does a really good job of just showing just really how amazing and how beautiful in a really dark way the fold actually is.
I was asking Brett if they were on the water because they're in boats. But they're not on water, they're on sand.
Yeah, but
I was trying to figure that out. I was like, are they on water or are they on sand? But see, the Grecians, they power the boat with their little wind power.
Yeah,
they can just glide over the sand.
I never thought about it until you brought it up. Of why are they using boats exactly? But I'm like, they can't use horses. They couldn't use live animals. I mean, because they would, you know, creatures would smell them and then they'd be dead.
But see, that one guy, how'd he get out?
The light saved him. See, he was able to make it to, what was it, West Rafka, because the light saved him. Just like it saved everybody saved the people that were still alive on the ship. That was how light saved them.
But we don't know, because we haven't watched the second episode.
You know.
No, I don't know. That's why I need to watch the second episode.
But at the same time, I will say, I really do think that they made the fold. I mean, it looked really ominous when you're going into it. I
it
like how
really
Alina. I
looked,
loved how Alina closed her mouth like she was
like,
about to go underwater.
I know.
Like she didn't even know what was going to happen to it. And then you get in there and you
and
just
dark.
See, yeah. And it's kind of, and it's kind of one thing. It's almost like a really, really bad dream where, you know, Mal's talking about it to Alina. He's like, I used to have these dreams
nightmares.
When I was a, yeah, these nightmares when I was a little kid about going in there and maybe finding my parents in it. And then when you go in, when you actually go into it, you learn just how decrepit it actually is and how basically, you know, there's, once you go in, the chances of you coming back out of it are just completely, it's almost nil, like coming out of it. And so it's kind
unless,
of.
Unless you have a light.
Yeah.
Unless
no,
you
but,
are the light.
Yeah, but I just feel like, I felt like they did the ominous part fabulous in this. I really did. Thought they did a great job with it. I thought the fold was beautiful in a really dark, sinister way.
And it makes noise, too.
Yeah, it does.
Oh,
kind of, yeah,
it's like
a weird storm in a way. Yeah, yeah, it almost feels like water that's going
It looks like when Moses parted the Red Sea, and
yeah, kind of is.
You had the wall, and you're like going.
Well, it's like
it.
Being underneath water is really what it is without being underneath water.
It's creepy.
But I felt like the Grecians. If there's one complaint I really do have with it, I felt like the Grecians. The build up to the Grecians of how special they are. I feel like they could have been a little bit stronger, a little bit at least showed some more fight.
Fight scene was pathetic.
Yeah, I felt like
it
the fight scene was really
the
bad.
The boat was on fire. There was a pathetic scene, but you know what?
Well, I mean, it's just like the Grecians just couldn't fight.
Overall,
well.
It was still a good scene because that's when the light she finally
yeah.
got her light. So that was a good scene, but the fight scene was horrible.
But you know, I feel like that could have been done a little bit better. Overall, I will say. I'm not a huge fan, like I said, of the Kaz, Inej, and Jesper storyline,
but it could get better.
Now, I haven't got to that. I don't know if that's in the book. I haven't got to that in the book.
Which half are you on the book?
I'm halfway through the book. And so I haven't.
And how many books are there?
There's a couple books. I got a long ways to go. But I will say this. I feel like that storyline could have been explained a little bit better in that I felt like it was really fast-paced where the whole Alina Mal storyline took its time to develop a lot better. That whole Alexei being, you know, spoiler alert, Alexei doesn't make it. And
I hate you.
Well, I mean, he died. He got shot.
Technically, he didn't get shot.
Yeah, he did get shot. He, like, literally got shot in the head.
Oh, the one that
was in the
chair.
Yeah, that was
in the
chair. Yeah, I'm like, that dude's, like, straight up dead. How did you get that guy got shot? The guy literally pointed the gun with, like, bang, bang. But I'm like.
Apparently, I wasn't paying attention to that.
But I just feel like, you know, that story maybe is going to be picking up a little bit better. But as far as this, I feel like it's a little bit more rushed where the Alina Mal storyline is, to me, just perfect in that regard. It takes its time to develop the characters.
That's because,
and it allows them to make
a
believable
Kaz
world.
And his group have a certain amount of time to get everything
yeah.
done.
But they didn't.
Because they have until dawn to get
yeah.
their team to get.
Yeah, but
you
yeah,
know,
yeah,
so.
Yeah, but that's the thing. I get it. They're rushed, but they're not able to develop that story and those characters. Like. We're just put into that world, and we're not.
It might slow down for them.
I hope it does. I hope it develops. Seems like there's a little something between Kaz and Inej to a certain extent right now. You know, he's trying to pay her off, basically, to get her free, her freedom. So there's going to be something more to it about that. I think that's going to be another little romance that's going to happen. But, you know, we haven't got to see... General Kerrigan yet. I mean, so the Darkling. So I'm like a
Who's
little
that?
Bit. You will find out. It gets better, guys. But as far as episode one, what would you grade this?
I would rate it as a 7.
I would grade it as, well, you know what? I would actually grade it as a 7 as well. I thought the fold is beautiful. I thought I enjoyed the
and they picked really good characters. For the series. I've never heard of half of these characters, but I mean the actors and actresses that play them. But they picked really good ones.
I think the actors all the way around do a fabulous job.
That's another reason why I vote as a 7. Plus, I'm not into stuff really that he's into.
Yeah, and usually she's not into the whole mysterious kind of thing. She's not really into anything that involves monsters.
So if I'm interested really into it. Everybody else is going to be interested.
Yeah.
Because I'm the
one. I mean, this is one of the top shows on television.
I'm the 1% that doesn't like anything.
Yeah, I usually know if she's into it, the average fan is going to be into it. Because I'm usually a fanatic when it comes to a lot of series.
And then we're also watching.
Yeah.
We're also watching. What's that other show that we're watching?
We watch so many shows.
No, the other one.
The Legacy show.
Yeah. We're watching the Legacy show.
No, it's called Legacy.
Jupiter's Legacy. Jupiter's Legacy. That's the next one. And I'm into that one, too. So.
But as far as this, I feel like the characters do a fabulous job. I feel like the actors and actresses do a really good job. The suspense is built up in a really good way. I feel like they do a very good job of developing Mal and Alina great in this. Like I said, I feel like they rush on the other storyline, the Kaz and Ej and Jesper storyline. But that would be where I would give it a lower grade in that regard. I like how they kind of build up the world. Where that they show that there's basically an aristocracy, where that the Grishas are the top level and everybody else is just kind of underneath them. I think that's interesting.
That's how it is in Avatar: The Last Airbender.
In a lot of ways it is. I mean, there is.
I'm gonna keep going back to that reference because it seems like it's like almost a grown up version of Avatar: The Last Airbender. You have the people that are higher, and then you got the people that can't do nothing being thrown out of
the garbage. I can't lie. It actually does, in a lot of ways, feel like Avatar: The Last Airbender. In a lot of ways. But hey, I'm a fan of that series. So, I'm not saying that in a negative light. I'm just saying it almost kind of does kind of feel like a ripoff of that. Just maybe,
but it's a good ripoff.
Well, we'll just have to see, But as far I think the Grishas do real well in it. But my only complaint is I felt like like I said, that one storyline was really rushed. Besides that, I don't have very much complaints about it as well. I was fully entertained from beginning to end,
and it might slow down. We'll have to see.
But as always, guys, thanks for watching. And let us know what y'all think.
Yes, please.
For episode 1 of Shadow and Bone. Did you love it? Did you hate it? Let us know down below.
Please let us know because we're going to be watching the second one.
Yay! As always, guys, thanks for watching.
Bye.
Take care.